Hi, it's Dwyer, DwyerVIP.com, here with a little free preview of some things to consider when analyzing the upcoming NBA playoffs. Right, I was in a bar the other day and we were talking about the NBA, and I know a lot of people like Oklahoma City. I know a lot of people like a bunch of other teams, the Chicago Bulls, etc., etc. But when there's money involved, we've got to look under the hood. You've got to look at the pluses and the minuses, and every once in a while, you get a game. Like tonight's Oklahoma City Thunder game, where they lost to the Memphis Grizzlies. That reminds you of a team's strengths and weaknesses. Let's talk about some things that you need to look at and you need to investigate on your own. I'm not going to make any picks in this video. I just want you to follow up on the numbers before you put any money on any futures plays for these NBA playoffs. First, Oklahoma City. I know they're looking great. I know they are the one seed right now in the Western Conference. I'm making this video early in the morning on April 3rd. But if you look at the numbers, you're going to see that Russell Westbrook's turnovers tonight against Memphis are not an isolated incident. In fact, the assist-to-turnover ratio for the Oklahoma City Thunder is a very disturbing 1.16, which is low by playoff team standards. To put it in perspective, the Philadelphia 76ers right now have an assist-to-turnover ratio of greater than 2. Right? No other team headed for the playoffs has an assist-to-turnover ratio as bad as Oklahoma City's 1.16. Now, I know that the media is fawning over Russell Westbrook, especially after he demolished the Lakers. He's no doubt a talent, but you need to look at him and you need to look at the other guards on the Oklahoma City Thunder, and you need to ask yourself what happens if they run into an excellent defensive team that gets a lot of steals, like the Miami Heat in the playoffs, right? I question whether Oklahoma City has the ball handling to win a title. Let's talk about the defense as well. Oklahoma City is also light on defense. They give up a whopping 96.7 a game. Statistics are stubborn things. That's a lot of points. You need to take a look at that. Let's talk about the Los Angeles Lakers. You know, something's wrong when Kobe Bryant has shot almost 200 more shot attempts than Kevin Durant. And by the way, he's not that far ahead of Durant in the chase for the scoring title. In other words, Kobe is a volume shooter at this point. Shooting 45%, that's a dream, because Kobe's below 45% on the season. If you look at the Laker defensive numbers, you're going to see that they're light on steals. They do have two dominant big men who are underutilized on offense. Sadly, on defense, they're light on steals. Right, I question whether the Lakers have the point guard play to win an NBA title. Right, a point guard would rein in Kobe, would direct more of the shots toward Bynum and Gasol, right, and would also be able to generate some steals. Right now, the Lakers are so inefficient that Kobe, of all people, leads the team in assists, and he's averaging less than 5 a game. I'm not sure if that's the winning ticket to win an NBA championship. Let's shift gears a bit. The Orlando Magic. You know, they're only as a team converting 64.5% of their free throws. Now, we've seen tonight, you had the NCAA tournament take place. We've seen some interesting teams in history. Faislam Ajama, Akeem Olajuwon, lose the championship game in college because of poor free throw shooting. Right? You can slow down the Orlando Magic, quite frankly, by fouling their players. I question whether a team with other teams that much better than them from the free throw line. I mean, understand you have some teams here who are converting more than 75% as a team from the free throw line. And here you have the Orlando Magic below 65%. I question whether the Magic shoot free throws well enough to win an NBA title. Let me also make the point, too, that the Los Angeles Clippers are also free throw deficient. They're hitting only 68.4% of their free throws. These are the things you need to think about, because in the playoffs, coaches will foul key players at key times. Free throw shooting is a bigger part of the game in the playoffs. More strategy is involved. And these teams right now are coming up short in that department. Let's talk about a red hot team, the Boston Celtics. Now, let me just say, I question teams that get on runs very late in the season. Understand, a lot of teams are hiding their playbooks. Right, a lot of these wins are against teams that, quite frankly, are resting players. Dwight Howard himself didn't play in the Orlando Magic's last game. Right? And so, Boston's winning streak doesn't really impress me that much. Well, nor does their rebounding. They're only averaging 38.6 rebounds a game. That's structural. Who do they have who's going to come in, especially against the better rebounding teams like the Chicago Bulls? Who's going to come in and pick up the slack for the Boston Celtics when it comes to hitting the boards? I think that's a big question. Not only that, of course, Ray Allen has been out. When he comes back, they're going to have to work through some chemistry issues. I just question whether the Boston Celtics hit the boards well enough to win an NBA title. Let's talk about the 76ers. You know, they actually look great statistically. Here's the problem. They only average 93.6 points a game. Right? Is that enough? I would also argue, too, that they have too young a mindset. I know this is a little bit off-road here, but I really question whether this team is going to have the mental toughness down the stretch against veteran teams like the Heat or the Boston Celtics. The San Antonio Spurs. If you look at the standings, you'll be surprised to see the Spurs are within 2.5 games of the Oklahoma Thunder. The Spurs look pretty embedded in the 2 spot or higher in the Western Conference. I know a lot of people are looking at them and they're saying, hey, what about this team? This team certainly has mental toughness, right? Guys like Tony Parker, Tim Duncan, Manu Ginobili, they have multiple rings. Right, they've been here and they've won it multiple times. Here's the problem. They're light on blocks, and that matters. In fact, they're light on defense. You heard me talk about The Oklahoma City Thunder giving up 96.7 points a game. The Spurs, on average, give up 96.5 points a game. That's a problem. Right? I would say that while the Spurs look good offensively, defensively, they look old and not as solid. Let me say this too, just analyzing the numbers. A team that surprisingly looks competitive almost across the board are the depleted but defending champion Dallas Mavericks. The one rub I see with Dallas is the offense, right? They're not averaging that many points per game. They're averaging 94.4 points per game. But in a defensively challenged Western Conference, I will say that this team looks like they are a wild card. I don't know if they win the West. I'm not making that production, that prediction. But all I am saying is that if you look at the numbers, the Dallas Mavericks and the Memphis Grizzlies actually look somewhat undervalued. Those are my thoughts on April the 3rd. I encourage everyone to look at the numbers themselves. Some of these teams are better than advertised. Some of these teams are worse than advertised. You get a glimpse behind the curtain when you see Russell Westbrook have more turnovers than assists against Memphis, a team that's very strong, and I mean very strong, in terms of getting steals. Right? Obviously, some of these teams are going to surprise some of us in the playoffs. Keep in mind, whenever a series is announced, whenever the seeding is done, there are props on how many games a series will go. And if you know that a team has a low assist to turnover ratio, and if you know that their opponent is excellent at stealing the ball and is also excellent defensively, causes turnovers, does other things, block shots, then I would say that that series is going to go a few games. Anyway, let me know what you think. Leave your comments for me here online. I will be breaking down for Dwyer VIP subscribers my picks on the series as they come to pass. Right, I will be making NBA predictions and doing further analysis. And some of my takes, as this video suggests, will be outside of the mainstream. I encourage gamblers, though, to look at the numbers and not just the media hype. Let me know what you think. I hope you visit us again at DwyerVIP.com. Thanks for stopping by.